All right, so yeah, we've got everything there in the photo. We've got all our buttons that we need, honestly, for that. The last one is the attendant call button. That's the one that sends a buzzing sound to the last locomotive if there's an engineer inside that unit to make sure he's awake on that part. So, got everything the way we need it on spacing aspect. But to make it look the way I need to, we're going to run it from there. So we've got a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 buttons. Which we actually have 5, 6. Starting off from, let's just say a total of, yeah, we're starting from there. So we've got 5 buttons now, because one is already set up, ready to rock. So now, we'll do 5 buttons to the center of 20. So 5, 10, 15, 20. 4, 8, 12, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So they're going to be 4 inches apart centered. So I love multiplication. Pretty darn easy. So 1 at every 4 inches is better. We'll do it 1 every 4 inches. So this part you can actually use your T-square if you really wanted to. You can actually mark it at 4 inches from the starting point. So 4 inches, we've got one right here, boom. So that's going to be one mark there. 8 is going to be right here. 12. It's going to be right down here. 16 is going to be here. 16. And then 20. It's really right there. Alright. Then you get your square, but it's a fucking triangle. It's a triangle, but it's a square, because if you use it correctly, it'll make a square. Then you mark your lines going across. That way you know which ones they are. So the big ones. That's the fun thing about wood. You know what I mean? Cause you want everything to look nice and neat on your project. Which honestly, I say I think it looks pretty badass. So. So you see where I had all my freaking holes from the old one. That was the fun part. So that's our switch. That's our DOT. Which we'll mark those on the other side. That way it tells us, okay, which buttons are going where. Now one of these actually on the EOT, we're actually going to drill out the hole, because it is the actual, it's a momentary toggle switch. So drill. On that one. Drill a hole for that bad boy there. Because on the back end, you're actually going to have to notch out a square. That way your switch can go in there recessed. And it'll stick out the way it does in the actual unit. So now we'll start drilling our holes. We'll make sure we got all that set there. You secure. here, pretty much.
I'd say so, yes, sir. It looks pretty good to me in my book.
So the first hole is going to be the squeech. We'll drill that sucker out. Take your time on drilling. You do not want to tear up the wood, even though we are using wood filler.
I tell you what,
we're going to see what we got on 30 millimeter. Damn it, hole socket. Let me see what we got here. I know I got it set here. Hole point at bottom. Milwaukee sells these guys for about $78. Yeah, you're investing money on this project. So in the long run, yeah, buy the stuff that you need. If I don't have the right size in here, I know I've got it in my truck. Which I'm hoping I do have the right size. No. I do not. No, not at all. I say not at all. So, why don't you keep that at that? It's in the truck and it's raining outside, and the problem is every time I go outside, I want a cigarette. So we're going to leave him blank. This one here, we're going to just say screw it, we'll drill it. We're center there, yes sir. Center, center. Sand right here. You do not want to drill on the wrong one. So you always do your lines the way you want them. Where you want them, nice, straight, center, pretty. Take your time on it, baby. So, are we going to use that? Do we want to? Can we? Yeah, we can pop a little switch right there, a little momentary style switch. That way when we talk, we can actually press it. Attendant call. So we'll do that like that. I believe I do have another momentary or a few momentary style switches put away. So we'll finish off drilling these holes with another bit on 30. Millimeters. That's a 30 millimeter bit. That's what you're wanting to use for all your push buttons. Because these guys, they secure onto a 30 millimeter hole. These are commercial grade switches. If you really want to buy the expensive ones, spend $300 on one of these. Yeah, they're expensive. But they're industrial. They last forever. You can actually really get the real ones if you talk to the right people off the websites from the manufacturers. You can buy the real locomotive switches. The company that makes them is Eton Switches, E-T-H-O-N, I believe. Or Eton, E-T-O-N, Eton. They're, one of their offices is off of 290 and West Little York, right there. Go under West Little York, follow the feeder road, you'll see Eton Switches, two-story office building. You can talk to them about what you're wanting to get if you're in the Houston area, or give them a call. Look on their website also for the switches. You can order them on there. But yeah, for this guy down here, we'll pop a momentary, and this guy here will do a momentary switch. So the next thing we're going to do is we're actually going to get our switch for the momentary style. And I'd like to see... the size hole that I actually need to drill. Now you can make it tight on the hole if you really want to. That's what he said. God. You can make it tight on the hole. No, let me flex my muscles. So our momentary style switch, which this one actually is the EOT. So whenever you click it, it stays on, it lights up red, and puts your train into emergency and you're fired. So you see that guy? He barely catches. So yeah, we are going to have to notch those out. That way we can at least have something for it to grab. So that will work there. So we're going to line up our drill size hole, and you can always make a couple pilot holes on a piece of wood if you really want to test it out to make sure it fits. That's perfectly fine on that part. And get yourself a set of cobalt drill bits, wooden. Get them during Christmas time, $20 at Lowe's. With inflation, make it 30 due to the piece of shit dickhead Biden and his cunt Harris. You can always drill a couple pilot holes if you really want to see if they do fit it, or see if it fits in one of them. Which, seeing this one, it does fit. Okay, and that one, it's a little bit, it doesn't fit. So this one, I'd say, would be perfectly fine. So if you can get a drill bit that fits inside there nice and snug, you're good. So match your drill bit to that guy, and we'll see what we got. So we've got a bit in here. I'm hoping I didn't break any of them whenever I did it, so that's a little tight there. So that's going to be a bit tight there. I did the assignment. There we go. So we do have the right bit for that opening. And we can drill it right there. So that's what we'll do now, is we're going to drill our bit for both of those holes. The size bit that you're going to be using is, I wish I'd fucking say, but it doesn't. But yeah, do a couple, well, it's the largest one out of the box.
And it don't fucking say what size they are, so...
titanium coating increases drilling speed and extends tool life. I wish this son of a bitch told me what size it was. They don't even put it on there, fucking Chinese bastards. Oh, cunts. So yeah, we'll drill the holes. And then we gotta chisel them out on the back end. And we'll drill the holes for these guys too, that way we've got our pilots. So we can pop them in there. I believe we're all the way through on those. So, I understand the assignment, the assignment, the assignment. Pay attention. I almost drilled the wrong hole. You see that? Always pay attention. Don't get above yourself. And it's a rolling thunder. Ah, 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 thunder. Ah, ah, ah. When you're building your locomotive control stand in the night. Make sure it's nice and straight, and then just take your time drilling. Thunder. 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 And just put all the dirt back in the hole. Okay. Because that will actually sand that down, make it nice and plush and pretty. That way our fuse fits right through there. So what we're going to do on that guy is we're going to actually chisel out a box on the back end, leaving enough space of plywood for it to actually secure to. We'll do the same thing here. Now, I wish I had one size smaller on this drill bit, but I don't. But I think we'll be okay with it. Because remember, we're going to be painting, sanding, and filling in, which is our next step after we get done chiseling these out. Oh, that reminds me. Correct. So we've got to drill out our holes for the boxes here. Correct. So, remember that I already got the opening back in here, so we can actually do a 30 millimeter inside here for the locomotive one, which we'll get that done now. So we'll get that done now. So we get that guy, get him right there, freaking center. Chunk out of there. It's all right. We got it. Still got plenty of wood on there. We're good. So one thing about fiber wood, man, is it sucks balls, but it works pretty darn good for small apparatuses. But on this one here, we've actually got to do holes the size of these. And that's where the Milwaukee set comes in. So for our rotary switches, these guys will actually sit inside here. So we've got to have an opening big enough for these to sit into and our wires to get past. That's the fun part. Yes. Well, actually, no. We're perfectly good on that part. We just have to have an opening big enough. Yes, we do. Correct. Yes. Okay. Got it. Perfect. That'll work. Don't worry. We got it. Okay, I'm curious as into seeing how that goes, because that's got to get inside there somehow. Yeah? Yeah. Yes, it does. I've got to drill the holes, put them around, and hook them up. Because that's actually going to go like that. Okay. This is the fun part, man. You're thinking a lot. You're like, okay, how are we going to do this here? So these holes have to be big enough for these switches to sit on. But the actual switches are going back on their original plates. Yes. That are there. But we can drill a hole big enough for it to actually sit inside there and get what we need to get. Which will give it plenty of support around it. Yes, yes. I understand the assignment, the assignment, the assignment. I understand the assignment. Yeah, I do understand the assignment. Now, yes, due to the fact those are actually going to be thicker and everything, those will fit in just perfect on the actual distance aspect of it, which we can pre-drill our holes around those. So if we can get something right there for it to actually fill, we can do that. So, that's what we're looking at. Okay, that'll work. So we get our bits, screw these bad boys onto there. Lock them into place, tighten it up, and we'll drive. poles. One's going to be here center. Yes. We want to make sure we're nice and center and center. And if we need to cut out a little bit, we can. Perfectly fine. Wouldn't mind getting a little bit of a bigger hole on it. Which this size bit is going to be a 2-inch. Actually, 2 1/4. 2 1/4. So I could do 2.5, but it's going to be a little bit big. So this is where you're going to get a file and everything and file it down if you have to. But we'll run our bits on 2 1/4 because these plates will be our plates that we're putting in. So they're actually going to sit right there. They're going to be nailed right in nice and pretty. And then they'll be painted black on that part. So everything will be painted black on that part. This guy will be painted black on that part. We're just going to flip him and make him look nice and pretty there. Yes, nice and pretty there. Nice and pretty. Yeah, that'll work. I understand the assignment. Yes, I do. And then we'll get a sander. We can sand all this down whenever we sand it. Pop it in there. Okay. Alright, so, drill our holes. I might go with the 2.5 inch. I might go with the 2.5 inch, yeah. We're going to go with a 2.5 inch bit on that, just to make sure I've got enough space on it all the way around. Because you're not putting pressure on the buttons or anything, but yeah, these sets, for the ones up to 4 inch on size, which is a complete box full of those bits over there. Yeah, you spend about $250 from Milwaukee. If they're on sale and you buy them with a bonus pack and shit, you know, you're gonna be spending about $500 some. Yeah, Milwaukee Tools, I tell you, man, they're a great company. They need to make a... Milwaukee needs to make a ladder that goes upstairs with water heaters. A Milwaukee ladder. Milwaukee water heater ladder. That'd be great. Battery operated. Two big old batteries like this. M18s. One per axle. Or per wheel. So we'll take a quick break. Pause. Alright, and so we're back. As you can see, we got tools all over the place. Another box of Milwaukee drill bits. You gotta quit watching me so hard, guys. You're making me fucking up. Alright. Yeah, if you're not a technician that does plumbing, electrical, or any type of woodwork, carpentry, or anything, you're going to have to invest in some tools. You're going to need a drill. You're going to need an impact. You're going to need a skill saw. You're also going to need a rotary or whatever the heck you call it. Pole saw. Skill saw, whatever. Yeah. Nail gun. Extension cord. And bits. So, yes, it is going to cost you some money to build this thing because of the fact that you're going to need the proper tools for it. So we are running 1.5 inches, and we will actually, yeah, we're wanting to run 1.5 inch hole. So we'll put this guy back away. So we don't need him. Right now, we'll get our 1.5 inch hole here. So this guy is 2.5 inch. There we go. So now it's 2 1/4. This one's 2.5. So 2.5 will work perfectly fine. Okay. So run our 2.5 inch hole here, centered. That's gonna give us plenty of space for wiring and everything to go through our hole. If we need to. That way we can get it in there, nice and snug. Whenever we put it in. Now the reason I built this thing the way I built it is because I got kids. Being good kids. Build it like you got kids. Because they put it to the max. Especially a 4-year-old. We don't need this anymore. Centered, yes, yes. It's gonna look good there. Looks good. So one thing you gotta do is take your time with these bad boys. There, centered. Make sure it's centered. So we'll pop our line across it just to make sure we're good here. See, if that's off of that hole, that's gonna be a little bit off. So our center line is gonna be right there. That's what we're looking at right here. Boom. And then our center line is there on that guy. We're reading 3 1/4. Flip it. Center, 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 3 1/4. It's actually off by a little bit. Mark that back, 3 1/4, center. Do 2-inch center there, okay. Measure that, make sure you're 2-inch center. Yes, 2-inch center. And now both of our marks here and here, if you can see, hopefully you can. Yes. Our center. Now we'll drill our holes for that guy. Now each locomotive is built different depending on which one you want to do. I'd say get a lot of pictures. That way you know what you're going after. Thank you. sometimes you have to use a pencil to get the piece of wood out of there. There's that hole. Clean that off. You gotta have rough hands for this job. Because if you don't, you'll get splinters and you'll be crying and be like, oh, my finger's infected. I need to go to the fucking doctor. Got our next hole here. Centered. Make sure. Yes, centered. Yep, centered. Good there. Now we'll drill. The assignment. I understand the assignment. It's sort of stuck in my head. I don't know where I got it from, but dadgummit. It's a horrible song. I'm hoping she passed freaking high school if she understood the assignment. So now our holes are drilled for our rotary switches. Which, if you don't got a strong wrist, that sucker will break your wrist, man. You try the whole hogs, those are even funner. Alright, so that's there. Hey, what do I got here? Alright, somebody's trying to escape here. Now we'll get everything cleaned up. All the dust vacuumed up. We got tools all over the place, obviously. Tools all over the place. So those guys will fit inside there nice and pretty. Pull plenty of space all the way around. These will bear cover plates, which you're gonna have four cover plates. One's gonna be a bogey. That's the way it looks inside the locomotive. That's the way it's gonna be on the actual stand. In case they wanted another switch for something, they've got it. So that's how that's gonna be done. I understand the assignment. Now we'll get everything picked up and vacuumed up real quick, so we'll take a quick break. Alright, now we've got it cleaned up pretty much. We're going to drill the back end of our holes here. As you can see, let's tilt you down a little bit there. Alright. This is the back of the unit, how it looks. We're going to grab our 30 millimeter bit again. I can find out where the hell I put it. Where did I put it? Oh, here. I'm going to put it somewhere. Hold on a second. Where'd you go? Cotton Eye Joe. There's a drill bit there. That goes with the bits. Okay, one second here. I don't know where the heck I put it. Hold on. Okay, where did I put you? I just put you somewhere. That's one thing, whenever it gets real late at night and you forget where you put you. There it is. Okay, here we go. Alright. So now what we're going to do is we're going to finish drilling out our main holes here. makes a nice clean cut. So. Stop you from going all the way through and fucking it up. So those are nice, good, pretty holes all the way around. This one just grabbed a little bit, but it's all right. Don't worry, it's okay. We're all in good hands, God willing. Now, that's there. Now I am hoping that I don't have to do this triangle again, because of the fact that. We can always test it to make sure we're good. So what we'll do is we'll take off our little rubber right here. You see? Take that guy off. Take him off right there. We might have to make this square box a little bit bigger to see if it actually fits. It doesn't look like it will. So this guy does go that way. He's gonna sit it sideways. Okay, let's get this guy here. See what the hell we see. So actually he fits pretty damn good. He fits perfect. Awesome. So, yeah, it's a perfect fit on that. That makes me happy. It's always good to test your openings. So you can always, because these are all 30 millimeters radius. Okay, so that fits, perfect. Fits perfect. Perfect. Perfect, nice and perfect, perfect. So good holes on that part there. All right, guys, you're watching me too hard now. Shit's flying in my hand. Okay. Put that back together. Put it back together. Just put it back together. It looks like a happy. Alright, bring it back together. I understand the assignment. What is the assignment? Okay. So that's there. So we're done drilling out those holes. Put our bits back with our bits. Okie dokie, artichokey. And we'll get this vacuumed up real quick. Always have yourself a good vacuum. The next thing you're going to have to buy is a good vacuum. Shop vac or dry vac, perfectly fine. So for our rotary switches, or our actual momentary toggle switches, which is the next thing that we're going to be doing. Yes. our momentary toggle switch, which we're going to have two of them. Okay. And if I can find them, where the hell did I put them? Where did I put them at? There you go. No, that's just a cover. Just a cover for that. Put it somewhere here. There he is. Okay. That's soldered onto there. Okay. Pop that in there, pop that in there. So for a momentary cell, toggle switches, which we're gonna have two of them. You're gonna have one here for the EOT, so you're gonna mark that out. Okay, now you can make it a little bit bigger, perfectly fine if you wanted to. And what you're gonna do is actually have to chisel it out. Okay. Now you do not want to go through the entire board. You want to just go through a couple layers. That way you've got grab onto there. And it's always good to have a sharp pencil. So we'll get a pencil sharpener here. I know I had one. Where did I put it? There it is. Okay. Get this thing nice and sharp. There we go. Perfect. Nice good sharp pencil with an eraser in case you gotta erase some shit. So that's what you're gonna be chiseling out there. Then I wonder if I have any more. Why do I have to show you? I really don't. Here you go. We do. Cool. Good. Hey, we got more. These might be actually multi-function toggle switches that I have right now. I will find out. But yes, they are toggle switches. Okay, they are momentary style. Good. So these are your momentary style toggle switches. You can get them off of Amazon for, I want to say, maybe $15 for a six-pack. Not a beer. But these are your toggle switches here. Now you've got your positive going in, negative going out. They are rated for 20 amp. Okay. 125 on the volt. So you can actually use 120. Voltage, wire, regular wire if you really wanted to. But the way they work is, see, when you let it go, it goes back to the off position. So if you want to talk to somebody, just press it and it provides power to your microphone. And then you turn it off. So we're going to use this guy actually on the bottom, which is down here. Yes, down there. And we're going to mark him. The way we need them. So now most of these guys, if I don't have to drill the hole, that'd be amazing, or bore it out like the other one, but most of them come standard size, so sometimes I do have to get them recessed inside there. and then tighten them up.
So all those pieces we'll put up with our switches. That way it's all the same and safe there. We will see if this guy actually lines up the way we want it.
And it does. Ooh, it might.
No, it does not. Okay. So this guy too, we're going to actually have to chisel out. Now there's some simple tools you can get on these things here. Flathead screwdriver on both of those. What you can use is a square if you really want to make it nice and straight. But I've got multiple of these because sometimes they do fail. And I've got one that did fail, so I'll be using another one of these. For the switch box. So where did my triangle go? There it is. Okay. So if we want it nice and straight, get it nice and straight here. Get the other one the same way. Alright, so that's what we're going to be chiseling out there. And what we want underneath that is an actual piece of wood. So it doesn't get fucked up while we're jamming down on it. Now you can use a utility knife. Which I believe I will do that. So, Or you can actually use a Dremel, which I've got one of those. Dremels work pretty good. I like them. And I think that's what we'll use. So yeah, one of these guys, $57, if not $60, at Lowe's. So as I say again, you are going to need some money for tools. Because this type of work that you're doing on this thing is somewhat precise. And it's somewhat of a booger. So, now one I want is a blade. I don't think I have one. Sand. That'll work perfect, actually. Yes, it will. Okay, so we've got our head that we're going to be using. And the fun part is locking this guy in and switching it out. So we'll plug him in. Make sure he is in the off position. We do not want it to turn on. Safety first. Because OSHA would not approve of that. Not at all. They'd be saying, oh shit.
Alright.
Yes, OSHA. They're dickheads for a reason, but they're good. Keep everybody safe and alive as much as possible. Without thinning out the herd. They try to prevent us from thinning out the herd from natural selection. Which means only the fucking idiots die.
Okay, here we go. So now we're going to start dribbling this out and that out. That way they can be recessed.
Thank you.
all dusty.
A little bit dusty there.
I understand the assignment. We get our flathead here. Would you get our toolbox, our tool bag? Where's our tool bag here of flatheads? Because anytime you need a freaking flathead, you ain't got one. Whenever you need it, you ain't got it. For some strange reason, there's a bag of flatheads right here. Ta-da! So now what we'll do is we'll just break that out of there really easily. Which, as I say, there's a Phillips, fucking Phillips star. Phillips. Star. Fucking Phillips. Socket. And no damn flathead. Fuck that bitch. It's alright. There's always more than one way to skin that cat. There's one piece. We've got quite a bit more to go. We want to get another layer if we can.
Thank you.
this is where it says, be very critique.
Very critique on it, I say.
See how that works. Let's see here. Where'd you go? Where'd you go, Kainajo? Because what we can do is whenever we put this guy in there, we can actually just fill it in with wood putty. You know, make it nice and secure where we want it. That way it doesn't move on us. So I think that'll be perfectly fine. Just put a piece of tape on it and you're good to go. Let it sit there and you're set. Yeah, because that'll give me enough of what I need to tie on. So I'll be good there. Something around I can save it with, but I don't. That's the problem. Got one of these guys, but he barely reaches inside there. It's okay. A little bit of wood filler don't hurt. So we'll work on the next one here. Shoot, if that's a freaking case, drop it down a quarter. Oh man. Wish that thing came with a guard. That'd be nice. But no, you've actually got to buy a router for that. a plunge router. That's what you need. I understand the assignment. You don't got a fucking flathead if you need a flathead. That's what sucks. Thank you. are you doing? Boy, I tell you, this takes a long time. Alright, let's see if that guy fits. Perfect. Okay, see? Now we're done with those. Alright, let me get everything cleaned up and we will start filling it in with our compound wood filler, stainable wood filler. Okay, you can stain it if you want it, but we're going to be painting it. Okay, here we go. So we're ready to fill in the wood with our wood filler. I don't know if you're supposed to use gloves with this, but I guess I only got one hand to find out. So we're going to seal everything up here. I always say just screw it, grab it with your finger, and get it in there. You're going to want to seal up all the crevices as best as possible, if you can. I'm going to give you extra support too, with the system in itself. Sometimes a putty knife just don't work. Yes, you gotta wait a few days for this stuff to settle up. Because I actually learned the hard way after putting it in and staining it. So, with that being said, patience is key. Understand the assignment.
This stuff does get a little dirty. So you have to get used to it a little bit. But it's easy to clean off. Once it dries up, you can actually clean it up with some sandpaper. So get all the crevices in there. Little crevices in there. Now I'll flip off to this side of here and fill all this in here. This is the fun part, you know. Getting your hands dirty and getting it in there. That's what she said. Make sure you don't play with the missus after you finish it. This guy in here. Now this stuff acts like a bonding agent too. That's one thing I like about it. This will actually help create a seal for your joints and take out any areas that could be an issue.
there. That's good there. We've got that all in there. And there. It dries pretty quick, so that's one good thing about it.
It dries pretty quick. So that's there. Now what we'll do is
flip it.
Start doing all the joints on the other side. To make them at least look nice, pretty, and decent. We're going to be sanding this down. So pretty damn. It's pretty damn good to get into. This shit's a pain in the ass. Might have to get a trial on this thing. Wait till it sets up more. Golly damn. It don't even want to stick on there. Shoot. Might have to do a freaking trial on this bitch.
try to let the truck I can get. You gotta have patience with this stuff here. You gotta know how to dap and cock it and get it all in the grooves. Door. get a trial real quick. It's going to make my job a lot easier.
Here we go.
Even better. Golly damn, I swear. Sand it down and fill it in, I'd say. But geez. Suck. Okay. I don't know. We'll find out how good we are with this here. Quite a while, but I'm gonna do this one last piece right here and call it a night because I am tired and I got a busy day tomorrow. But I'll fill all this in and we're gonna let it sit up for a few days. And while we do that, let it sit for a few days, we're going to actually be you suck. So what we want to do is have all the holes and gaps filled in and make it look nice and pretty, darn it. Oh, we're fun. All right, we'll sand it all down. So we used a ton of wood filler. Not a ton, but quite a bit. And, looks like shit, but it's okay. We're gonna make that shit turn into diarrhea and be a beautiful piece of nincompoop. Yes, it will. We'll sand that down. Take a sander to it. Make it look nice and pretty, God willing. Then we'll dap and silicone the actual joints to make them nice and smooth. I just want to get all the wood filler in. That way it dries. That way then I can sand it and do what I got to do with it as best as I can. So let that sit overnight. And we're done for the night. But that's part of building your locomotive control stand.